Hello, everyone. This is Ashley Tucker from My Favorite Things. Today, I have a really colorful rainbow birthday card to share with you using a couple of things from the latest release. First, I grabbed a piece of white cardstock and I cut it down to 5 by 3¾ inches. Next, I took out the Star Pops die set. Now, this die set has two different dies in it. One of them cuts out 3 rows of small stars, and the other one cuts out 1 row of large stars. I decided to keep these two dies together and not cut them apart, and I used the dies on the upper left-hand corner and the bottom right-hand corner, going at an angle. I set that panel aside and I pulled out the Balloon Bouquet stamp set, which has this large stamp of a bouquet of balloons. I put that in my Misti tool and I stamped it with some Copic Friendly black ink onto some white cardstock, and I'm going to color those in with my Copics. Like I usually do, I kept the coloring very simple for this. I didn't want it to take a really long time and go for a super realistic look, and instead I just used 2 colors on each of the balloons, and I did it really quickly. This didn't take very long at all to color in. If you want to know the colors that I'm using, I did put the marker caps off to the side there so that you can see those colors. I started out by filling in the entire balloon with the lighter of the 2 colors, and then I added some shading with the darker one, and then blended it out very quickly with the lighter one. I actually think I was being a little bit messy with my coloring on these balloons, and that's because I knew that later I'm going to come in with a white gel pen and add in some highlights, and it doesn't really matter if the coloring is super messy right now because once I add in those highlights, the balloons are going to look so much better. So if you are trying to color in balloons and you're really new at coloring and you don't really know what you're doing, I would recommend filling in the whole balloon with your lighter color and then taking a darker color and just adding it to the center of the balloon in a circular shape and then blending that out and then adding in some really nice highlights with a gel pen later. And I'll show you how to do those highlights when we get to them. For now, I took the coordinating die and I cut out those balloons. And I also used the die on a piece of navy cardstock. And I'm going to glue down the balloons to that navy cardstock. And I'm going to kind of offset it a little bit so that I have a drop shadow on my balloons. Eventually, I'm going to be gluing these balloons to that white panel that I made at the beginning, and I wanted them to kind of stand out a little bit more, so that's why I added the navy drop shadow. Alright, so now I'm starting to add in those gel pen highlights. I'm not thinking too much about a light source here. Balloons are really reflective, and they have lots and lots of highlights. If you want to do highlights the way that I'm doing them, draw lines and dots right along the edge of the balloon, following but not actually on top of the outline of the image. And then I also add a larger dot or 2 on the inside of the balloon, kind of off center. All right, so next I picked out a bunch of really pretty colors of cardstock that I like, and I'm going to cut some strips from those. I tried to pick out colors that kind of match the balloons that I colored, and I'm going to be creating a background out of these strips. I took out a panel of A2 size cardstock, and I added my tape runner all over the front of that so it's completely covered in adhesive. Then I very carefully placed each of those strips of colored cardstock, making sure to really, really press them up against each other so that there's no paper showing in between. This is really one of my favorite techniques. I absolutely love being able to make my own customized pattern paper using any colors that I want, and I love rainbows, and this technique really lets you make rainbow pattern paper. I used my paper trimmer to cut off all of the excess paper so that I have an A2 size background, and here I'm gluing my balloons onto that white panel that I made in the beginning of the video. Next, I'm going to add some foam tape on the back of that panel, and I made sure not to place any of that tape on my stars so that you can see the background through those little holes. I was very careful when I placed this, and I actually made sure to stand up so that I could look over the top of it and get it lined up perfectly. I then took that whole thing and I adhered it onto an A2 size card base. For my sentiment, I picked out one of the stamps from the Balloon Bouquet stamp set, and I stamped that with some Versamark ink onto some black cardstock, and I made sure to prep that cardstock with a powder tool before stamping. I then embossed the sentiment with a white embossing powder, and I cut it down into a strip. I decided I wanted the ends of the strip to kind of follow along the same diagonal as the stars, so I just kind of eyeballed that and marked it with a pen so that I could cut it out with some scissors. I added some foam tape to the back of that sentiment strip, and then I popped it up right on top of the strings of the balloons. I wanted to add some embellishments to this, but I wanted to make sure not to go too colorful with them because I already have a lot of color on this card. So I picked out these raindrop embellishments and I added those kind of following the same line that the diagonal stars create, and I glued them down with some liquid adhesive. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed this card design. This is a really great design that I think can be recreated in a lot of different ways using different colors. I hope that it gave you some inspiration and that you'll give something like this a try. Again, thanks for joining me, and I hope you have a really great day today.